So this video is about M5Dial, modular programmable dial that combines a rotary encoder, a touchscreen display, RFID scanner, and much more in a really compact design. And this is a complete guide about this product where I'll be covering its unboxing, the hardware overview of the product, the technical specifications of it. Then we'll learn how to use this with Arduino IDE. Later, I will teach how to get the factory firmware back onto the device. And in the end, we'll conclude this video by discussing about what kind of projects we can make with this super compact device. So let's quickly start with the unboxing of this product. So this is how you'll receive the product in the plastic case. And here you can observe a couple of its features mentioned both on the front and back side of the packaging. Now let's open it up. So in the casing, first of all, we get to see the actual product, and my first impression was like, wow, what a beautiful product, and this rotary encoder feels really satisfying. Now then the product, we get the Allen key driver and a terminal connector which we can attach on the backside of this product to give the external supply to it. And that was all about the unboxing part. Now let's discuss the hardware overview of the product. So this device comes in the size of 45x45x32.3mm size and has built-in 1.28-inch circular TFT touchscreen display with a resolution of 240x240 pixel. Around this display, we get the grey border which is both a rotary encoder as well as a push button. After this grey border, we get this orange ring which is a removable ring, and with the help of this, we can attach this M5Dial on any glass or acrylic surface by just creating a hole on it. Then on the back, we get to see a battery connector for external supply, two ports, port A and port B for connecting external I/O devices, a reset button. And this complete device is based on this stamp S3 board from M5Stack, and it can be programmed and powered up with the Type-C port. Now here if I remove this case and also remove the stamp S3, we can see a battery socket in it for a small backup batteries. But here I think the M5Stack company should provide that small JST connector for battery, because getting this really small JST connector is very difficult in the market. So with this, we are done with the hardware overview of the product as well. And now before discussing about the technical specifications and features of it, let me first thank to my sponsor and let's see what they have to offer you. So this video is sponsored by NextPCB, using which you can get delivered 5 PCBs in India at somewhere around 100 rupees per PCB. So NextPCB is one of the most experienced PCB manufacturer company in China, which is working since 15 years now. Here you can get your PCBs manufactured within as low as 24 hours and has a variety of shipping option which you can choose to get the best PCBs at best rates. So here to order the PCB, you just need to upload the Gerber file of your PCB project. And here on the platform, they have an amazing Gerber viewer using which you can visualize your PCB file and also turn on and off the particular layers on it. And along with this, you can also select the ruler to get the dimension of your PCBs in real time. Then you need to select the number of PCBs. Well, here the minimum quantity is 5 pieces, and select the color masking. I will select the green one here. And after that, you will get a price calculator on the right hand side that will tell you about the total cost. So here it will cost me around $12 if I select the manufacturing time as 24 hours. But if you're not in hurry, you can select the 48 hours time slot, which will reduce the price of the PCBs a lot. And then here we have couple of shipping options available, in which DHL is the fastest one. But again, if you're not in hurry, you can select the 4px shipping option that will reduce the shipping charges as well. And now the total price comes around $6.6, which is around 110 rupees per PCB, which is really affordable. So I'll leaving away all the necessary links down in the description of this video. So do check them out, and maybe you can try NextPCB for your next PCB order. And now let's get back to our video. So now talking about the specs of this board, then this is based on ESP32-S3FNH chipset, which is based on a dual core Extensa LX7 microprocessor clocked at 240MHz, and this version got a built-in 8MB of flash memory in it. It also got a 2.4GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 5 support. Then M5Dial has built-in RFID module based on WS1850S chipset, which works on 13.56MHz. It also got a BM8563, which is an I2C based real-time clock. Finally, it also got a tiny buzzer in it, which is really helpful for audio feedbacks. Now this device can also be powered up with an external power supply ranging from 6V to 36V. And those were the complete technical specification of this board. Now let's power up the board and let's see what we get inside the built-in factory firmware. So let's power this device with the Type-C cable, and at the beginning let's see what we get. So we get the M5Dial text, and we get a circular menu which we can, you know, change all the options with the help of the rotary encoder, and this small little sound makes it feel really good. This is nice attention to detail. So we have different sound for the anti-clockwise and the clockwise direction. So first of all, we get the option as LCD test, and I can select this option by just pressing this rotary encoder, and it says change the rotary encoder to change the color, and I can see the red, green, blue, white, black, and the white. And here I can touch on the display and I can see the coordinates as well. So this is the display and the touch panel test, and I can exit this by just pressing the rotary encoder, and can switch to the next option, which is the RTC time, that calculates the time since the device is turned on. So the device is turned on since 1 minute as of now. Let's go back to another option. So we have the RFID test, so I can go inside this menu, and here it says place your RFID card above to read, and I have an RFID card here, so I can place it above it, and as you can see it scanned the tag and we got its serial number as well. So that's the RFID test, you can see. Then we have the brightness set. I can go inside it and I can increase the brightness. The maximum is, I guess, 255, yes, and I can decrease the brightness as well. Good. So I can go back. Oh, it's not visible. Let's go inside it again and increase the brightness. Okay, let's go out now, and I can select the Wi-Fi scan option where it will scan the nearby Wi-Fi networks and show its list on the display. I can move up and down using the rotary encoder, which is good. And let's go to the Bluetooth one. Then we have the Bluetooth server. That's a BLE server, and we don't have anything to do here as of now. Let's go back, and we can go to the temperature control demo. Now I think this is just a demo which is shown for controlling the temperature in our smart home, we can say, but it's very good. It's like complete big display, big numbers. It feels really good. It's good for the thermostat. Let's go on to other option, which is mode. Inside the mode we have the quit option, the power off, and we have the LVGL widget, so it has the LVGL support as well. So I can go inside it and I can, okay, I can swipe left, right, and I can move up, down, and yeah, that's the LVGL demo. I can go back. Inside this we get other LVGL benchmark test and other tests, and this is really long list. This is a nice little text, but it is not working. This is just for showing that it can do a really lot of things. So yeah, that was all about the built-in firmware, and that's all we get inside the built-in firmware. The other two options are blank. We have nothing here. So that's the complete factory firmware, and that's what we get inside it. And now let's see how we can program it with Arduino IDE and what do we have in its built-in examples. So now to get started with using M5Dial with Arduino IDE, you first need to install the M5Stack boards packages. Yes, they do have their own boards packages. So you need to go to this page whose link is in the description, copy this URL, and then you can go to files into preferences. And here you can click this icon and just paste that line here. Click on OK once again, and then you can go to tools, then into boards manager. Here just type out as M5Stack, and you need to install this boards package. Now I am having the version 2.1.0. Click on close button, and now you can check the M5 related boards all in your Arduino IDE. So you got support for all the M5Stack boards. Now the second step is you need to install the library. For that you can go to sketch into include libraries into manage libraries. And here you can search for M5Dial. Then just click on the install button, and here you need to install all the libraries like M5Dial, M5Unified, and M5GFX as well. So I click on install all. And with this, we are done with all the basic configurations. And now you can go to the files, examples, and then directly into M5Dial. And here you can see we got all the basic example codes for each of the feature. Maybe it's button, maybe it's buzzer, display encoder, RFID, RTC, touch, and wake up. We have the example code for all the feature, which is kind of a great thing because we can understand all the function with that basic code. And then we can later on merge one or two feature in a single code to make our own project. Okay, so I'll just show you by uploading one single example code to just let you know that how you can successfully upload the code into your M5Dial device. So here I'll maximize this window. And now you need to go to tools, and into the boards you need to select the board as M5 stamp 3, because M5Dial is kind of an add-on to M5 stamp 3. The main controller is still the M5 stamp 3, so you need to select that only. And after that you can again go to tools and just select the right COM port and just hit the upload button. Okay, so the code is successfully uploaded, and let me just turn on the smartphone screen to let you know what's inside my M5Dial. So this is the button test example code. So I can just press the button and you can say it says pressed, it says released. Pressed, release, pressed, release. And I really like the font on this display. This is really cool. So this is a very basic example code just to test the button on it. And similarly, we do have several other example codes like the buzzer one, which works something like this. The display example code to test the display. The encoder that will help you to visualize how you can increase and decrease the number. Then RFID example code that will help you to scan and read the RFID tag. Then the RTC example code that will help you to visualize the current time with both the internet and also with the help of RTC. Now the display orientation is not perfect, so we are not able to visualize the data completely, but after modifying the coordinates, as you can see, now I'm able to visualize all the data on the circular display. Then we have the touch example code to test the touch panel. And the last one is the wake up example code, which works like this. So in the wake up example code, it says press button to sleep after 5 second wake up. So I'll press the button and this goes to sleep and it will wake up after 5 second. Let's just see. Yeah, so it turned on. So that was the basic wake up example code that will help you to learn how you can make this M5Dial to go inside the sleep mode. So those were the basic example code, and that's how you can start working with the M5Dial using Arduino IDE. And now, let me show you an interesting way about how you can get the factory firmware back. Well, this is really interesting because M5Stack did a very interesting thing here. Let me show you. So till now, to get the factory firmware back in all the ESP-based devices, we used to download the firmware file first, and then we also used to download the flash download tool to do all those steps of burning the firmware. But now, M5Stack did a really interesting thing, and what it is you can just download the .exe file. Well, first of all, this is just for Windows, so sorry Mac users. So you can download this M5Dial test demo, which is an .exe file. As you can see, it got downloaded, and I can double click on it. I'll click on more info and click on run anyway, and it opened up a dialog box where I just need to select the right COM port on which I have connected the M5Dial. So currently the M5Dial is running the encoder example code. So it's connected to COM7, and just click on the burn button and it will start flashing the firmware inside your ESP device, which is awesome and very, very convenient. Great job, M5Stack. And we are done. It is that simple. And now, as you can see, I got that original factory firmware back. I hope you can see it. Let me just zoom it in perfectly. Okay, so this is the original factory firmware which came along with this device. So we got our factory firmware back onto this device, and this was a very convenient way. And they do have one more firmware file, which is M5Dial Smart Home Panel Program. So just click on it and it will also start downloading that file. And later you can double click on that file, click on run anyway, and just click on the burn button and it will start flashing another firmware. Okay, so the firmware is flashed successfully, and let's see what it has. Okay, so it has a smart home kind of theme where we can select different appliances. Let's go inside the light, and here we can dim the light, and also by clicking the button, we can change the temperature of the light, like warm white and cool white. Okay, and we can long press to go back, and we can select different option. This is just a demo. It is not doing anything in my home or my office, but this is kind of a demo, like what you can do with this small dial. Long press to go back. Okay, so yeah, that was a super simple step to get the factory firmware back and also try out different firmwares. I hope M5Stack do this for Mac users as well, so that we can flash the firmware file from our Mac systems as well. So that was all about M5Dial, a really unique kind of IoT development board. And based upon its features, well, there are tremendous possibilities of different kind of projects that you can make using it. For example, I tried to make my own IoT remote control with RFID access. Let me show you a demo. So that's the IoT remote made using M5Dial, and right now it is waiting for a valid RFID card, otherwise it won't work. So here's the valid RFID card. I'll tap on it and it says welcome, and now I can control my studio like this. I can press a button and it says light one on, so it will turn on the light one in my studio, which is running on the Blink IoT platform. And by rotating the dial, I can turn this light off as well. Similarly, I can press a button to go to the light 2 and I can turn on the light 2. Similarly, I can press a button, go to light 3 and turn on the light 3 as well. And similarly, I can press a button, go to light 4, I can turn on the light 4 as well. Not only the lights, but I can also turn on the fan or control the fan speed. So right now I set the fan speed to 2. So as you can see, slowly the fan started turning on. I can set to fan 3 and fan speed 3 and speed 4. As you can see, this fan speed slowly started increasing. Okay, so that's how I can control my complete studio using this IoT remote made using M5Dial. And similarly, we can make many different kind of projects, like RFID based access control system, attendance system, a HMI for a vending machine, and many, many more. So now you share your thoughts about this M5 dial down in the comments of the video, and share your thoughts about, will you be using this different kind of IoT development board, or you'll still prefer the regular ESP3 development boards? Do share your thoughts, and also share this video with all your IoT enthusiast friends and let them know about this latest IoT product that is launched in the market, and also ask them to subscribe so that they get notified with all the upcoming videos similar to this one. So yeah, that's it about this video, and now just wait for my next video, and then explore, learn, share with me, techiesms.